This talk will be about urban agriculture challenges and opportunity. Urban agriculture is the cultivation of vegetables and plant and the raising of animal, poultry, fish within around city limit to provide fresh food, create employment, recycle waste, and strengthen city resilience to climate change. Urban agriculture alleviates poverty and reduce food insecurity resulting from urbanization. At the same time, improving the health of city residents and conserving the environment. Urban farming is growing or producing food within a city limit. At the onset of the current COVID-19 pandemic, many countries impose lockdown to prevent the spread of the virus, resulting in the distributions of food supply chain, food shortage, and panic buying. Consequently, countries, including Saudi Arabia, have strengthened their food security. Readily available fresh food within city limit has been seen as one of the solutions to provide food for citizen and resident. Many governments have encouraged their population to harness urban agriculture. Some countries have distributed vegetable seed to enable people to grow vegetable in their community. Let's talk about Singapore, for example, has allocated $30 million for urban agriculture, like vertical farming, for their food security. Let's talk about Saudi Arabia. It is no exception. The leader has allocated 100 million Saudi riyals, which is about $27 million, to develop and localize vertical farming technology. The crucial importance of urban agriculture emanated from the Saudi leadership spread head by the Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman, launching a development strategy to transform the city of Riyadh into one of the top leading economy in the world. Currently, Riyadh ranks 40, so we want to go from 40 to 10. Leading the Riyadh City implementation strategy is the Royal Commission for Riyadh. By monitoring and measuring more than 50 performance indicators based on a benchmark from the world leading city. The paradigm shift encompasses the pillars of Saudi Vision 2030, which is vibrant society, thriving economy, ambition nation. To achieve a sustainable economic, social, and environmental society, under their Riyadh City Development Strategy by 2030, the anticipated population will double from the current 7.5 million people to 15 or 20 million inhabitants. And there is expected to be an increase in the number of visitors to 40 million people to visit Riyadh. Riyadh's competitive edge is that poses a well-built infrastructure ranging from the most advanced modern information technology to a modern road, literacy rate of 97%, and an educated young population, and is a key contributor to the Saudi Arabia economy. Regionally, the Middle East and North Africa is already 64% urbanized. Much of the region's future urban growth is up in absolute term is projected to occur in the region's primary cities. Although faster growth in a relative term is projected to occur in its secondary cities, conflict and climate-driven immigration, as well as cross-border movement driven by the search for economic opportunity, are unique consideration in the region and have been overriding some secular urbanization trend in a subset of countries, according to the World Bank. Global migration is over 54%, according to the United Nations. One of the critical contexts of the rapid increase in urbanization is that it tends to increase urban poverty and urban food insecurity, and the number of people requiring clean water and sanitation. Urban agriculture could improve the availability of sustainable supply of fresh and healthy food for all residents within the city limits for a short period or time. Urban agriculture creates opportunity for employment. It enhances food security and subsequently national security, with Saudi being a food secure country. During the time of crisis, like the current COVID-19 pandemic, country lockdown, civil war, restriction on import, it has significant role in providing emergency food supply. The international community is beginning to recognize the important role of urban agriculture in improving the economy, environmental, and health of cities. Hastening urban agriculture from all the stakeholder perspective, including institutional, entrepreneur, supply chain, consumer, and producer, is potentially beneficial for all the key players. There are several types of urban agriculture that can be classified as the follow: vertical farming, hydroponic, aquaponic, aeroponic, backyard, roof, top garden, animal husbandry, urban beekeeping, greenhouses. Different type of urban agriculture, we talk about vertical farming. An agricultural process in which crops are growing in a vertical stack layers rather than a spread out horizontally in a traditional rows in a field. We talk about hydroponic. Hydroponic, it's allow the root of a plant to grow in a water solution instead of soil. Aquaponic, it's combine plant cultivation with aquaculture for fish farming. Aeroponic, a method that allow for potential better oxygen access for plant, even less water usage and lower chance of transmitting disease. Backyard or roof garden, this is growing of food on people home properties or building in building properties. Animal husbandry, rearing animal for food in urban setting, such as poultry, goat, rabbit, or sheep, and so on. Urban beekeeping. Bees are important in the ecosystem as they not only produce honey, but act as pollinators and promote biodiversity. Greenhouses. The practice of a greenhouse is residential, commercial, and commonly urban space. It gives farmers the ability to grow a crop all year round, as they provide controlled environment where crops can be subject to a specific condition required for their growth. We look at urban agriculture through the lens of sustainability, triple bottom line, of economic, social, and environmental benefit. Let's talk firstly about economic benefit. It generates income. Urban agriculture leads to the establishment of a new business and not only provide income to the owners, but also create employment opportunity for people in the cities or community. There is a local government benefit. It enables the local government to raise revenue, providing education and training, skill improvement and training for jobs opportunity. Need minimum amount of water to grow vegetable and plants and raise animal, poultry and fish. Secondary, social benefit. Create community participation. Urban agriculture provides an opportunity to a local communities to participate in related activities. Maintaining of culture. Culture practice are also shared. Continuing local interaction through urban agriculture activity create an integration, bond, and people from different age bracket get to share significant information about certain food crops, vegetable, indigenous herbs, and domesticated animal such as poultry. Health, nutrition, and food accessibility benefit available of the varieties of fresh food and food security. Thirdly, environmental benefit. Improve urban environment community, support biodiversity, and improve air quality. Reduction of local carbon footprint help in reducing the carbon footprint of the farm, especially in emission from transporting mediums. The green plantaries also go a long way in acting as a carbon sink, particularly through the practice of urban forestry. Crop preserving and new crop development. Urban agriculture creates a home for pollinators to increase the chance of preserving indigenous crops, which may not fare well under other conditions. It also leads to the breeding of new crops by sharing seed. Urban agriculture derive activity, create opportunity, as well as challenges for all the stakeholders. We will be talking first the opportunity that include the following. Require minimum packages, storage, and transportation of food at its closer to the city limit. Provide job and income. Ready available of fresh food. Waste recycling and reuse possibility. We'll talk now the challenges. Some of the challenges include environment and health, risk from unacceptable agriculture and aquaculture practice. Increased competitiveness for land, water, energy and labor. Reduce environmental capacity for population observation. Let me summarize what I want to say. To summarize urban agriculture, it provides many benefits, especially as regard to food security in time of a crisis, for example, the COVID-19 pandemic. During lockdown, access to fresh fruit, vegetables, are within the city limit, provide income, and reduce environmental impact through less transport and packaging. Create employment opportunity and training. To conclude what I want to say, the need for holistic and multi-sectoral approach to understanding and responding to urban agriculture is important. In particular, where the growing population in city need to have an alternative or supplemental income to meet their expenses. Strategic ways of dealing with competition for water and land, as well as other environment concerns, must be developed. A research center for knowledge, equipped with the technical capability to evaluate the appropriate place for urban agriculture, for sustainable agriculture and urban food system, is required. The application of technical knowledge with psychological and economics expertise, as well as practical experience, would be an innovative and timely initiative for a sustainable urban agriculture to meet the need of those living within the city limit with easy access on fresh food. Urban agriculture is not providing food only, which is important. It is also entails food security that will enhance the national security of a country. Thank you for watching, and I'll be happy to receive your comment and questions. Thank you.